Matt Makens here, time for a weather watch. What's with all this heat? What's driving this somewhat stagnant weather pattern as well? What's bringing in smoke from Canada and other fires across the country? Chatting about that in today's weather watch. If you're new to the channel, thanks for joining me. Really appreciate it. Returning viewers, let's get at it. You kind of know what I'm about. Let's chat about June. Every red dot on this map was a record high temperature set in the month of June. And you can see some concentrated areas. We have some isolated ones outside of Denver, but we have the Pacific Northwest, kind of a concentrated area of some of the records. And then we have here the upper Midwest into the New England states and then down into Texas. That's where we've seen the concentration be highest of some of these daily record high temperatures, especially out of Texas. That's where a lot of the headlines have been coming from, is the heat there. And the problem with that is that unlike some other locations in the country, the heat has been so persistent, it's not just setting daily record highs, it's also about setting streaks of record temperatures. And this weather pattern is not moving around very much at all. It's stagnant, as I just mentioned. And part of that is not really helping the air quality issue. To have stagnant weather pattern over so much of the country, we're drawing in wildfire smoke, we're adding some new fires across the U.S., So here's the alert map, and I made this on Wednesday, and it shows some heat and fire concerns, not only for the Southwest and out into California, but a huge, huge swath of heat advisories, excessive heat warnings, excessive heat watches, all across the southern plains into the southern Mississippi. And then all of these gray boxes you see from the upper Midwest, Great Lakes to New England, mid-Atlantic, down along the Atlantic coast, that's for air quality. So it's a combination of heat, low-level ozone, and wildfire smoke creating that. When you see maps like that in the midsummer, early summer, it's a stagnant weather pattern, and that's certainly what we have. Now for the air quality, you can get air quality issues with low-level ozone. That's just from heat combined with our pollutants, cars and lawnmowers and all that. But we've had this impact of all the wildfire smoke really concentrating out across the east, and that's where the air quality issues are. Let's run through that animation again. This is wildfire smoke as projected from Wednesday into Thursday and also Friday, but a lot of it's coming out of Canada, and we're adding sources from Mexico, Southwest. There's new fires in western Colorado, the Spring Creek fire, seen some fires in Wyoming too. So we're adding a lot of other elements to the stagnant weather pattern that are just creating some of these ill health effects. It's not just the heat. I mean, that's a huge factor, don't get me wrong. But adding in smoke and just the stagnant pattern is really creating some issues. And is this likely to change? Not so much. Let's just talk about what happens the very end of June, and let's go into July, and what is driving this pattern. Driving, pun intended, what drives your car? Most of our cars, a lot of our cars. A piston engine. How does a piston work? You add fuel here, fire it, it pops, so you're adding energy, you're driving that piston up. And what happens to the engine? It's a cyclical engine. So as one piston comes up, another piston has to drop, right? It's all about keeping a balance within the engine. When you add energy to the atmosphere in one place, there needs to be compensation somewhere else. So let's chat about that as it applies to weather. Now, where are we adding the fuel to the piston engine? We're adding it in large part to these very hot ocean basins. We have very hot equatorial Pacific, especially right near South America. That's the ENSO region, the El Nino region. We have El Nino. The northern Pacific has a huge area of very hot ocean temperatures as well. And that stretches from Japan and toward China and Southeast Asia, very hot pockets of ocean there. And it goes all the way up toward British Columbia. And another area, well, actually two, off the coast of Africa is one, but biggest is in the North Atlantic. So these areas of hot ocean, they're sources of fuel. They're the energy driving that piston. If you're driving heat into the atmosphere, you're punching up the atmosphere in those places. And somewhere else, you're creating a trough. So a trough, top of the piston where you've added energy, that's your ridge. Let's see how this unfolds. Let's take a look at the atmosphere during the month of June. And when we've created some of these record heats and this kind of stagnant weather pattern, the oceans aren't moving around very much, right? So those blobs of heat in the oceans, they're going to fluctuate very, very slightly. the atmosphere above will react to that, and they'll react relatively slightly as over a long-term average anyway. So this is June. We're looking from the north, like a satellite, an astronaut on the North Pole looking down at the atmosphere, looking down at just the northern hemisphere disk, if you will. And where do we find those pistons? Where do we find that punch? Well, we have one over the North Atlantic, over the heat. We have a couple of bullseyes here, those pistons pumping up over the hot Pacific. And where you're punching things up, you have to compensate that in another way, because the atmosphere is an engine. So we're taking away, we're reloading the piston, if you will, in some of these blue shaded areas. So much for the month of June. We've had a piston applying heat and energy across Mexico, and that's been moving into Texas and will continue to spread northward. We've had a piston with lots of energy, heat energy, and a stagnant pattern basically over Hudson. And that's creating kind of the stagnant air over Canada, the extreme temperatures over Canada, and it's also grabbing that smoke and sending it toward the U.S., sending it toward that piston that we're trying to reload there. North Atlantic, you're going to hear a lot about that blob of heat from other sources, online, videos, wherever, and myself going forward too. That is really going to be the driving piston, if you will, driving atmosphere for Europe throughout the summer. There's going to be drought issues, extreme heat issues based on that piston. And throughout much of June, that was the strongest piston, if you will, it was the strongest ridging, strongest high pressure area, strongest heat dome, all those terms you probably have heard already, in that area of the North Atlantic. And that's going to be a driving factor for the rest of the summer and likely into fall as well. So let's put this all together, okay? We've discussed what's driving this engine, where we're applying heat or energy to the system, to the engine, and what's it look like going forward. We wrap up June with risks of hazardous heat. Not just Texas, we're spreading it toward Kansas City, St. Louis, Nashville, Atlanta, down throughout Florida, all the way up toward almost Norfolk. Also, the Central Valley of California, some extreme temperatures there. That's to wrap up June and start July. Let's get into the first week of July. Now we're going to be talking about risks of exceptional heat across the Pacific Northwest in Washington and Oregon. And we're spreading it from Arizona to New Mexico, Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Missouri, into Illinois. We've got Louisiana, Arkansas, all of these states down here still dealing with the extreme heat. Record-setting highs continue. As mentioned, it's a stagnant weather pattern. It's going to take some time. It evolves, it ebbs and flows, but we're kind of locked into this extreme heat pattern across the South for the foreseeable future. What about the month of July? I went into the first week of July. What happens the rest of the month? This is the projection by the CPC. So this would be generated by a number of computer models that are kind of created as an ensemble, a great deal of recent history and trends. Persistence is a factor into this forecast, as well as some additional forecaster, say, biases. I'll say biases, but not in the negative way. I'm a forecaster. I'm sitting down. I think this is happening. I think maybe we can take some equal chances in here and kind of massage the data a bit. So factor all that together, and that's how CPC produces theirs. For my clients, my July outlook is somewhat different. I have more heat in other locations and a little cooler in others. And that's based on my forecasting biases and my perception of how soil moisture feeds into cooler July in some cases or hotter July in some cases. So my clients are going to see a different forecast than what you see here. But this is very representative and very, very good forecast for July. And we're still looking at odds very likely to be above normal with temperatures and continued heat across southern Texas. And then we expand that region. So likely July stays in the stagnant weather pattern. Part of that will be wildfire smoke, air quality issues, growing drought. All of those things we'll talk about on future videos, just like we've done with past videos. If you want more on El Nino, there's a video for you. See you the next time.